We're looking at the planet Earth from 185 miles in space. These official NASA films taken by astronauts Michael Collins and John Young through the window of the Gemini 10 capsule also show the Agena target rocket with which the spacecraft rendezvoused and will shortly dock. Only 7 hours of this three-day mission have elapsed when both craft locked noses. Shortly afterward, Agena's powerful engine pushed them to a record 475 miles out in space. Separation occurs nearly 39 hours after the link-up. During that time, astronaut Collins took pictures from outside the capsule. They rendezvoused with Agena 8, and Collins' half-hour spacewalk led to retrieving an object from the dead Agena. With the critical danger of the re-entry phase over, the 4-ton spacecraft, blackened by the tremendous heat of friction, floats to a pinpoint splashdown. The settling parachute resembles a giant jellyfish. Within minutes, rescue helicopters are over the bobbing capsule and Navy frogmen drop into the water. A life raft and a special flotation collar to keep the spacecraft from sinking are also dropped into the Atlantic. Astronauts Collins and Young return to their native atmosphere with several space firsts, all of which give America's space program invaluable data for the upcoming Apollo moon mission. The Gemini twins elect to wait in the rubber raft for pickup by the helicopter. A space physician at the scene said they looked better than when they took off. The tricky technique of hoisting both men into the helicopter begins. These scenes are among the most dramatic splashdown and rescue pictures yet taken in the Gemini program. One of the first things done by the NASA doctor after splashdown was the swabbing of the astronauts' eyes and noses to determine what caused the severe irritations during their first open hatch maneuver. Encore of the first hoisting operation takes the second astronaut from the raft up and into the helicopter. The lifting speed is a bit slower than the 17,000 mile an hour pace of their orbiting Gemini 10 capsule just a few hours before. Aboard the carrier Guadalcanal, a hero's welcome awaits the two spacemen. As they stepped on the deck, the band played "It's a Big, Wide, Wonderful World." Collins told the cheering crew, "Thanks for picking us up. You did a beautiful job." Space pioneers, Young and Collins, triumphant twins of the Gemini 10 mission.